morning students. Today we will do chapter number 3, The Way Animals Talk, for our term 2. Now, the way animals, they talk, we talk to each other, we communicate, we express our ideas, our feelings through our speech, okay, or gestures maybe, like I do. So some body movement also we do. Suppose I say yes, we say no. So these are the different gestures we do, or body movement we do. Suppose I don't know the answer, I shrug my shoulder. Okay. So this is the way the human beings communicate. But children, animals, they don't talk. How do they communicate? They communicate with the different body movement and gesture. They also communicate. They also, they live in their groups or in their herd, they have to communicate, they have to send some signals, message. So this is how the most common things they use is body movement or gesture. Like the birds, they chirp, they make the noise. Or the dogs, have you seen dogs wagging their tails when they are very happy? Okay, so this is the, there are different ways the animals make the different sounds which show that whether they are happy or they are sad or they are in danger. You see, watch the Animal Planet, please watch these shows in Animal Planet or Discovery Channel, where they show how the different animals in the animal kingdom, they communicate with each other. So human beings and animals, they need to communicate to survive. They want to live, they have to survive. And unlike humans, they cannot speak. These animals, they can't speak. Human beings can speak, but the animals can't speak. But they have to send some message, like suppose there is an animal which is going to attack them. Like the deer, all the deer is moving and they see a tiger or a lion going to attack them. It makes them sound like a patient body movement. So even these deer, the monkeys, they also make the squeaking noise to show that there is a danger, they are in danger. The most common way by which animals communicate is body movement or gesture. This body movement. The dolphins, when they want to seek attention, they slap their tails in the water. When they want attention, the children want attention from their parents. So they make some noise or something. So dolphins, what they do, they slap their tail in their water and they want to show that they want some attention. Now children, when bees are in search of their nectar, honey, when they find some nectar, they keep on dancing. That shows that other members of the bee family, they understand that they have got some nectar. So bees communicate their finding of nectar by dancing. So they keep on dancing. Okay? An animal use sound to communicate because it can travel a long distance. As I told you, if you watch the Animal Planet or Animal Kingdom, that some animals, other animals like monkeys also, sometimes they make sound to warn the animals that they because they sit on the trees, they are in the trees, they can see their lions or tigers or leopards, and they are going to attack the smaller animals. So they make the sound, and this is like this sound they can the smaller animals can understand that there is a danger or some wild animals is going to attack them. So sound travels faster, so they make the sound to communicate. And birds like robin, cuckoo and magpie, they make beautiful sounds to communicate. They have a beautiful sound of the cuckoo bird. So they communicate, they make beautiful sounds. We have seen peacocks, they dance in the rain. That is also that they are happy. They show, we have seen dogs wagging their tail, or sometimes the dogs' ears are down because they are sad. So these are the different ways animals communicate with each other. As we communicate with our speech or gestures, with body movement, animals communicate mainly with gestures and movement.